All right, in the talk back, in the talk back. I know, I'm being quite emphatic about the European Union being involved as part of the liaison of the money system between the sovereignty of opera houses. Now, we don't have to use the EU. We can always just be the sovereignty of opera houses that uses the embassies directly and pays for the embassies directly. Based upon the savings of the bulk products that we purchase, and based upon rebuying, let's say you're going to put on a Swan Lake, you rent the set from us instead. You rent a set of a Swan Lake, and so you pay for the workers that way. And so it can be a full organization that is just using the business aspect of it. We don't actually have to include the European Union at all, but nobody has actually contacted me, and so I'm out here left in this strandation place of having to contact a Marie, having to contact a local government authority, and so there is nothing I can do aside from run and start screaming and yelling that the European Union has to be involved. So I'm a little disappointed that the whole system, that it is relying upon the European Union, when we can be a sovereignty of opera houses instead. Just have our business entity that does supply enough money to buy the bulk products and rent out the used sets, the recycled sets, back to the theaters and to save them money. And then also in sync at the same moment pay for the wages of the workers that are the former dancers, the former musicians, and the former opera singers, of all these performers. So I'm like, well, yeah. So we could have gone that way, we still can, but right now I'm kind of in a desperation where I have a Marie and a social service worker that apparently are making decisions for my life. And I really need some dedicated decisions here for the entire group, how we're gonna run it. Are we running to the EU? Running to the EU for assistance? I mean, it seems almost retarded, doesn't it? Seems like we can handle it ourselves. We already have all of these things at our fingertips. We already know. I don't know why my camera's moving. But yeah, we already know. We already know all of the logistics of it. So it's like, well, what's the deal? We can make it an enterprise, a business of our own. We don't have to include them as being the one who passes the savings money back to pay the wages, because that's what would happen in a triangle relationship. You have the, let's say the EU is the top of the triangle, and over here we have the buying center on this side, and over here we have the opera houses. And so at some point, the money, the saved money, the EU is going to say, hey, give me the saved money so I can go back and pay the wages of the workers. And so this is what's going to happen to us. And so we have to try to avoid that. And yet, in the same token, we cannot defriend the European Union at all. We have to maintain friendship. Even to the point of demanding an extra taxation on every tourist, €1 to support the arts, and meaning each plane that goes through, they have an extra euro they have to pay. That is a good way because they're getting free performances in parks, they're getting free performances, you know, all around Europe. So that's a good thing to put on any international flight, would be an extra euro. And that would go towards the sovereignty of opera houses, and that will help the whole contingency. So we can use the EU that way. We can use the EU that way, and they can be very helpful. So let's not forget that version. You can go ahead and say tax the rich an extra euro now and then, but I don't know. I kind of like just let's tax the ones on the airplanes, you know, international flights. That would not be a bad idea. Because they're getting wonderful music. They're getting wonderful music in a park, you know, by for free. You know, I've walked by and gotten to listen to free music by wonderful musicians. So you know, I didn't pay for that moment, but perhaps the €1 entry on the airplane would solve it, would solve the little extra that we were looking for, that doesn't, you know, seize us out into firing the performers. Now, if we have opera houses out there that are playing a little nerve kitty, like, well, we'll just cut the dance out this year. You know, we paid our opera singers too much. We just paid our opera singers way too much money. We just cut out 10 dancer jobs. You know, if they're playing these stupid games, if we have one opera house that is kind of like a rogue event, that is being stupid, that is running out and saying that I have to hire the most expensive opera singer in the world every single night, you know, it brings in, okay, I'll give them that, it brings in the extra few people, maybe the following night's going, she's not here, so good for you. You do bring in the commercialism moment, however, that doesn't necessarily pay the wages of the other performers. So we end up with quite a dissonance, don't we? We end up with a dissonance when you have the 10 that are the most famous in the world, and then you have the others. Yeah, so anyway, I would prefer this. We can keep it a sovereignty of opera houses. I would prefer that. Oh my gosh, look at me. I'm not broken Russian today. So what does that mean? I don't know. Maybe because my Italian fortes were so terrible. That's it, you know, I can't even speak broken Russian anymore. Back to school, back to American school system, oh my gosh. Yeah, they're fun to try, but yeah, you have to have good pointe shoes at the ready. So yeah, be careful with those. Try to keep the leg tight behind and high in the front, and you should be okay, and then straighten that arm if you can, and then you'll be all right. Yeah, I know, mine are not something to look at, and stay in one place, so yeah, we know all those things. But anyway, what was I trying to say? I would love it if we could just keep it our own little business, the sovereignty of opera houses, and our own little business that has the used equipment center that we rent, and we re-rent our costumes, and so they don't have to be repurchased, and we don't have to, remake the sets, repaint the sets, and so all of this saves the original opera house money, and then back to the bulk, and so they buy at the bulk also. However, we may not, in that version, we may not be able to pass exactly the cheap price, because we would be simply a business, so we may have to add on extra and not just give you the great bulk price, because we're avoiding the EU. We would be avoiding the EU in that moment. The EU won't get the savings out, you know, each one gets the million savings plucked away in the European Union wants it, you know, wants it to repay the embassy. And so that's, you know, so we would take their repayment plan away, you know, so the 1 million that was saved from Stuttgart or saved from Zurich would be not given to the EU to repay the workers of the embassy and the 1,000 there with this retirement. No, it would be absolved into the prices of the buying scheme, that you're still buying from those suppliers, and it'll just be in there, and that would pay for the workers, that will pay so we have at least 1,000 of us still have some kind of a retirement with a dignity, so we're not foraging in the back ways of Europe for food. So yeah, let's do that. Let's do that, everyone. Let's try to think, gosh dang it, wouldn't that be better to just avoid them having to get in there and pluck that million out? Because if they take the million, then we're gonna be like, wait, when do we get it? When do we get our million? So there is that kind of a weird moment. And in a way, it's better if we just keep it our own little snuggly bunny. You know, you just keep it as tight as possible. Our 50 or so opera houses, and then our business, our purchasing center, and also I may need to mention we'll make brochures. We're going to make brochures specific for the A theaters, the B theaters, the C theaters, the D theaters. And with those particular prices, so you're used to buying a C theater price for your costumes. This is what you have available. So we'll not be tempting you with the A prices, and we'll not be tempting you with the others, the D prices or the B prices. So if you're a specific theater, you'll get the brochure for it. So with the sets, we're going to have. Each set, and its specifics, little photos of each, and so it's kind of going to be like a brochure deal, an ordering book. So we're going to have an ordering book. So if anybody's a talent at that, that would be really, really clever to include them as part of the group, part of the group of 1,000 there. So thank you. I think I've said enough. I think I've said enough for today, but yeah, I don't know. Gosh dang it. Yeah, maybe we can coerce the EU to just put on an extra euro on the international flights into Europe to support the arts, and then they get, and also that 1 euro can go towards the nonprofit, not the nonprofits, the other ones, not just the state theaters, but the other ones that are out there that are called, they have a special name. They're public funding, yeah. So it will go to the public funded groups a little bit more. So, but I don't know. I think we can help also. I don't know. Do we have to be their watchdog and say that this is not really a group, and I don't think they deserve public funding. To that degree, maybe we will be that. Maybe we will be a vote that is not really a group I want to receive any of the tourist incoming money. So we can have that impotence moment with the European Union if the European Union is going to be there collecting that euro. We can use it and be guiders, because I don't want everybody to just get money because they have a group of dancers that walk in a row. You know, that's not good enough. It's just not good enough. So we have to have some kind of stipulations. And we can't have too many of you out there just running around saying, I'm a dancer. You know, it's just stupid. It's just stupid. You know it. We have to have some kind of, and if you have too many, if there's a glut on anything, it just takes away from the benefit of it, you know, just takes away from it. You can't have too much of anything, you know. Anyway, well, yeah, except football, apparently you can always have too much of football. Yeah, well, anyway, I guess that's all for today.